मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई पारुल मैडम वेलकम यू ऑल इन द ऑनलाइन ज्योमेट्री क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू लेसन नंबर 12 स्मार्ट चार्ट्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट। Today, we are going to learn to read and make bar charts. We are also going to gain sense of approximation. Hot and cold. Children, do you watch TV or do you read newspapers? If you do, then you might have seen weather report on TV or a newspaper. This report states the weather of major cities, that is, the day-to-day temperatures of major cities are displayed. Here you can see two bar charts. This shows the highest temperature in degrees Celsius of four cities: Delhi, Shimla, Bengaluru and Jaisalmer, on two different days, that is on 1st June and on 1st December. Children, do you know that temperature is measured in degrees Celsius? On 1st June, the temperature of Delhi was 33 degrees Celsius. The temperature of Shimla was 22 degrees Celsius. The temperature of Bengaluru was 28 degrees Celsius. And that of Jaisalmer was 38 degrees Celsius. On 1st December, the temperature of Delhi was 23 degrees Celsius. The temperature of Shimla was 10 degrees Celsius. The temperature of Bengaluru was 24 degrees Celsius, whereas the temperature of Jaisalmer was 25 degrees Celsius. As the temperature increases, the place becomes hotter and hotter. So, on 1st June, Jaisalmer's temperature was highest, that is 38 degrees Celsius. So, Jaisalmer was the hottest city on 1st June. On 1st December, again, Jaisalmer's temperature was maximum, that is 25 degrees Celsius. So, Jaisalmer was the hottest as compared to Delhi, Shimla and Bengaluru on 1st December. It is a fact that as the temperature decreases, the place becomes cooler and cooler. So, on 1st June, Shimla was the coldest city as its temperature was lowest, that is 22 degrees Celsius. On 1st December also, Shimla with temperature 10 degrees Celsius was the coldest city as its temperature was the lowest as compared to other three cities, Delhi, Bengaluru and Jaisalmer. Now next question is, which city shows little change in temperature on the 2 days, that is 1st June and 1st December? The change in temperature between Delhi is 33 minus 23, that is 10 degrees Celsius. The change in temperature between Shimla is 22 minus 10, that is 12 degrees Celsius. The change in temperature between Bengaluru is 28 minus 24, that is 4 degrees Celsius. While the change in temperature between Jaisalmer is 38 minus 25 gives 13 degrees Celsius. So, Bengaluru shows little change in temperature that is 4 degrees Celsius. Try yourself. Children, you have to try yourself now. On any one day, choose any three cities and record the temperature from the TV or newspaper. Then make a bar chart and ask your friend a few questions about it. One such bar chart I have done for you. I have considered three big cities, Ahmedabad, Delhi and Shimla. On 1st May, I have noted down their temperatures. Temperature of Ahmedabad was 45 degrees Celsius, Delhi was 35 degrees Celsius and Shimla was 20 degrees Celsius on 1st May. Then I have drawn this bar chart based on this observation. I have even framed some question answers. First one, which city was the hottest on 1st May? Answer is Ahmedabad, since the temperature of Ahmedabad was maximum, that is 45 degrees Celsius on 1st May. Second question is, which city was the coldest on 1st May? Answer is Shimla was the coldest on 1st May with lowest temperature of 20 degrees Celsius. Third question is, what is the difference in temperature between Delhi and Shimla? Answer is, temperature of Delhi was 35 degrees Celsius, whereas temperature of Shimla was 20 degrees Celsius. So the difference in the temperature is 35 minus 20, that is 15 degrees Celsius. Rabbits in Australia. Children, you might have heard of a country named Australia. Am I right? Earlier, there were no rabbits in Australia. So many rabbits were brought to Australia around the year 1780. Even at that time, there were no animals in Australia which ate rabbits. So the population of rabbits began to increase or multiply at a very fast rate. This table shows how rabbits grew every year in Australia. At the start, that is in 1780, 10 rabbits were brought. At the end of first year, that is in 1781, the number of rabbits increased and became 18. At the end of second year, that is in 1782, the number of rabbits became 32. At the end of third year, that is in 1783, the number of rabbits became 58. While at the end of fourth year, that is in 1784, the number of rabbits increased and became 108. So at the end of fourth year, that is in 1784, there were 108 rabbits roaming in Australia. Now answer the following questions. First one, after each year, the number of rabbits was dash. Four options are given. One option is right. A, a little less than double the number of rabbits in the last year. B, double the number in the last year. C, 8 more than the number in the last year. And D, more than double the number of rabbits in the last year. Correct answer is A, a little less than double the number of rabbits in the last year. See how. At the start, there were 10 rabbits. At the end of first year, there were 18 rabbits. That is, double of 10 is 20 and 18 is little less than 20. At the end of second year, there were 32 rabbits. Double of 18 is 36 and 32 is little less than 36. At the end of third year, there were 58 rabbits. Double of 32 is 64 and 58 is little less than 64. At the end of fourth year, there were 108 rabbits. Double of 58 is 116 and 108 is little less than 116. So as the year progressed, the number of rabbits were a little less than double the number of rabbits in the last year. Now, question number 2. At the end of year 6, the number of rabbits was close to. Three options are given: 400, 600 and 800. Answer is 400. Let us see how. It is already given that the number of rabbits at the end of fourth year were 108. Double of 108 is 216. So at the end of fifth year, there were a little less than 216 rabbits. Now, double of 216 is 432. So at the end of sixth year, there were a little less than 432 rabbits. And this 432 is close to 400. So the correct answer is 400. That is, at the end of year 6, the number of rabbits was close to 400. Now, next question number 3. After which year did the number of rabbits cross 1000? From answer 2, we know that the number of rabbits at the end of 6th year, that is, in 1786, were close to 400. Now, double of 400 is 800. So, at the end of 7th year, that is in 1787, the number of rabbits were little less than 800. Now, double of 800 is 1600. So, at the end of 8th year, that is in 1788, the number of rabbits were little less than 1600. Now, we can see that 1600 is more than 1000. So, after 8th year, that is in 1788, the number of rabbits crossed 1000. Hope to meet you in next online geometry class. Thank you. Take care.